Hello everyone, welcome to Build AlgoLogics. So in this video we are gonna learn how can we write our code to print this zigzag square pattern. So without any further ado, let's get started. Here I am assuming that you are already familiar with how to print normal square patterns using stars or numbers. Let me first briefly introduce you what is square pattern. So for printing square pattern, we have to use these two for loops. This is the convention that I'm using for making understanding of these programs simple, like numrows for number of rows and row well for each value of row and col well for each value of column. If you don't know the basics of this pattern, you can watch my first video of a square pattern using stars. I'll give you the link in the description of this video. So let's begin with this first pattern. Alright, so although this pattern seems printed in this way, but as we know, as a programmer, our code will print these values from left to right only, means from this left end to this right end. And if we reach here, it will again start from here and so on. And why it would be starting from here? Because we are using this new line character, which is used for separating each line. Alright, so let's analyze this problem first. At the very beginning, the first line printed the values from 1 to 5, and this 5 is nothing but our numbers as we are declaring here. But the main thing is, this value is incrementing by 1 each time. Now let's see what this second line is doing. Here we are starting with some arbitrary values. We'll see it soon what it is. But here the main point is, this value is decremented by 1 each time. This behavior is same for all the values of rows. It means for odd number of row values like these one, we have to increment the value of number to print variable by 1. We are gonna use this variable to print each value. As the starting value of this pattern is 1, we will initialize this variable by 1. And similarly for this even row, while printing numbers, we have to decrement this value by 1. So it implies that we have to work differently with each number of odd and even rows. So our condition will be like this. Here we are using this modulo operator to get the remainder, and as we know, this statement will always return 1 or 0 because we are using this 2 as our divider. And what modulo operator will do, it will return the remainder, and return value will always be 0 and 1. Here, if return value is 1, it means we are dealing with an odd row, and if it is 0, we are dealing with an even row. So according to this condition, we can separate our this logic of incrementing and decrementing. Now let's see what is the starting value of each line. So for the first line, we are starting from 1, and the second line is starting from 10. Similarly, this third line is starting from 11, and so on. So let's see what is the relation between these starting and ending values. So here this first line is ending after printing 5, and the second line starts with 10, means the difference between these values is nothing but the 5. Similarly, second row ends with 6 and the third row starts with 11. Here also the difference is 5 because 6 plus 5 is 11. Let's also see this end value and starting value of this fourth row. Here also we are getting the same different. It means that for starting value of any row excluding this first row, we have to add this 5 into the previous value whichever we are getting. And this value 5 we can get from this numbers variable. Let's write our code for this problem first. Here this variable is used for printing each values. Then here according to our condition, we'll increment this value by 1 because this block will execute for each odd value of row well, and similarly decrement this value by 1 here if the row is even. We also need to print this value, so let's write one printf function to print this value. Now as we know, every time we have to add this num rows in this num to print variable. So before going to next row, means after printing all these 5 numbers, we have to update this value in this way. Otherwise, it seems like we are done, but wait, let me first run this code, and yeah, this output is not the one that we are expecting to have. And why so? Because here, as we are incrementing or decrementing this value by 1 for each of these iterations, And we also know that this loop will only get terminated when the value of call val is 1 greater than this value, this condition value. For example, every time for terminating this loop, call val must be greater or equal to 6, that is 1 more than this numros value, which in this case is 5. And because of this only, values of this num2print variable get affected. So for making them consistent, we also have to add or subtract 1 from this value before adding 5 into it. And this adding or subtracting will depend on whether we are coming here from printing odd row or even row. Because if it is an odd row, we have to subtract 1 from this value, as this increment statement will increase this value by 1. Similarly, if the row is even, we have to subtract 1 from this num2print variable. We can achieve this by using if else block in this way. Now let's run it. And yeah, we got our expected result. Let me also add some formatting to make it looks good. This is just for formatting number values. It's good idea to use number formatter for printing this value instead of using spaces. In this way we can format our number output. But now, although this is fine, but I want to make some changes in this part to make it looks clean. Here as we only have one statement inside these both if and else blocks, so instead of using this if else block, I'll use the conditional operator to do this job. In this way, here when this condition returns true, we are subtracting 1 from this value, and when this condition returns false, I will add this 1 into it. Now again run this code, and yeah, we got the same output. Alright, so we have successfully write our code to print zigzag square pattern using numbers. So now let's see how can we print alphabets in this manner. But before going to make changes in this code to print alphabets, let me first briefly tell you how these characters are stored inside the machine. These all characters are represented by some numbers, like small a is represented by 97, similarly small b is represented by 98, and so on. In similar manner, capital A is represented by 65, and the capital B is represented with the number 66, and so on. These numbers are actually called as their ASCII values. Means ASCII value of small a is 97 and ASCII value of capital A is 65. Similarly, for small b it is 98 and for capital B it is 66, and so on. I'm not gonna confuse you more with these ASCII values, but if you want to learn or are interested to know more about these ASCII values of different symbols including these alphabets, you can just Google it and you will be able to find some best examples with their explanations. Here I'll show you some basic examples that we are gonna use to print zigzag pattern with alphabets. Now let's see some examples to better understand the conversion of these characters. In C programming, conversion between these symbols and ASCII value is very straightforward. You just need to specify the type of the variable. Let's declare one character type variable with default value as A. Now as we know, for printing this capital A, we have to use this %c format specifier inside printf function. This format specifier is used for printing single character. Let's run it to see the output. Here capital A is printed as we expected. Now if you want to print its ASCII value, we just need to store this character in int type variable in this way. This statement internally assigns ASCII value of A to this ASCII value variable, because at the end, ASCII values are nothing but some integer values, means conversions would be happened internally. We don't have to use any extra functions to perform this action. Like in Python, for getting ASCII value or sometimes called as Unicode of any character, we have to use ORD function. And also for getting characters by using ASCII value, we have to use CHR function provided by the Python module. Now let's print it by using this format specifier. Here it is. As you can see, ASCII value of capital A is 65. Similarly, you can find ASCII value of any symbol. Not only this, C language also allows you to perform any arithmetic operation on these characters. And why so? Because these characters are nothing but some integer values. And we already know we can perform any arithmetic operation on these integer values. Let me show you one example of this. Let's see what will happen if we add 1 into this A. Now again run this code, and yeah, we got this B printed, and also a ASCII value of B, which is nothing but 66. Now as we got some ideas of alphabets representations, let's make some changes in this code to print alphabets instead of these numbers. So for printing these alphabets, we just need to change this variable as char data type and assign it initial value as capital A. You can also use small a if you wish to. That's it. Now let's run this code. This is the output that we are expecting. Here, instead of printing numbers from 1 to 25, now we are printing these characters from A to Y. But this is not the general solution. What does it mean? Let's see. Let's assign this numbers with the value 6. Now again run this code, and yeah, we got this strange output because here we are exceeding the limits of ASCII value of characters. Means after printing this Z character, the next character according to ASCII value table is this one, and so on. But as we want to print only alphabets, means after printing this Z character, we'll again print A, then B, and then C, and so on. So what's the solution? Let's understand this first. As we are having only 26 characters, whether they are from small a to z or capital A to z, just see this blue table. Here you can see that for printing A, we are adding 0 to its ASCII value, and similarly for printing B, we are adding this 1 into this ASCII value of A, and as a result we are getting the ASCII value of B. Similarly, to get the ASCII value of C, we are adding this 2 into the ASCII value of A, and so on. It means that we can limit this number to always have the value between 0 to 25 and add them to the character A to get the respective character. So for this purpose, now we'll use one char to print variable as a counter whose value will always get incremented. So before going ahead, let's make some changes in this code as we discussed earlier. Let's run this code again. This output is same as before, but now we can limit this char to print counter value to always return numbers between 0 to 25 using modulo operator. Modulo operator in C program is used for getting remainder after performing division operation. So now before adding this value into the alphabet A, we'll use this statement. This allows us to have values only from 0 to 25. Let's first run this code. And yeah, this is our final solution. Let's see why this solution is actually works. See this blue table. Here, when we divide 0 with 26, the remainder will be 0. Similarly, when we divide 1 with 26, the remainder will be the same value as 1, because these all are the values which are smaller than this 26 and hence not divisible. But when this char to print value becomes 26, this time the remainder will be 0. And why so? Because this time 26 is completely divisible by 26. That is why we are getting this remainder as 0, and because of this only, we are getting this A printed again. Similarly, when char to print becomes 27, we'll have remainder as 1, and adding 1 to this value means printing B, and so on and so forth. Hope you got the idea. If you haven't understood any of the part, please rewatch that part again. You will definitely get the answers of all your questions. But still, if you have any difficulties to understand any of the concepts, please do let me know through the comments section. I'll try my best to clear it out. Thanks for the patience. If you like this tutorial, please click on the like button and share it with your friends. Also subscribe the channel and don't forget to press the bell icon to never miss out any incoming videos like this one. And that being said, see you in the next video.